facial recognition systems are ubiquitous in that they are already commonly used in personal devices, and we've become accustomed to them already. I would say perhaps we're not quite yet accustomed to things like facial recognition in airports, but I imagine that the more ubiquitous it becomes and the more required it becomes to be able to, you know, use the airport, the more people will become accustomed to it. The concerns that people have about facial recognition are around areas of bias, so that the system might perform poorly on certain groups of people while performing better on other groups of people. And then another area is obviously consent and agency over how this is deployed on you. It's interesting to kind of try to measure the accuracy of facial recognition software. I think people take accuracy as this kind of universal metric that you can improve upon for something like facial recognition, but it actually really depends on the data set you're using to train and test the model. It could be problematic for these systems to perform poorly on transgender people or other minority groups, because they often are deployed in really high-risk scenarios. So, for example, in the airport, people are thinking of or already using facial recognition to match, for example, the person in front of the camera to their identity documents. And there have already been known issues for transgender people because maybe their appearance has changed over time. They probably will be here to stay, but we can change the course of how they're deployed and how they're developed by conducting research in this space, proving when and where bias is occurring, and pushing legislators to really care about how facial recognition is being used and who is using it.